Welcome to my nightmare castle.
He's a celebrity. He's a celebrity. He's probably talking.
He's getting stopped, signing autographs, kissing babies.
Yeah, you know, we're done. All right, yeah, yeah, it's awesome. We get it.
So, what do you think of TV?
This is your first time.
It's my first TV.
It's been amazing. I have not played a lot of pinball though. Too much talking, and that's actually been fun. Too much talking.
Yeah. Oh my god.
I mean, I like a dream. These guys are fucking gold medalists.
Let me house these school inadequate, dude. Trust me, I've learned my lesson. I honestly don't drink beer anymore. It's just now that it's really hard to talk to people too, so now it's like you meet with them, shake hands, give me your card, let's have a call or meet somewhere else outside. You know, because it's conventions are always that way. You can't really talk to that many people. Plus, you can also be careful what you say. So I'm guessing there's gonna be a lot of stuff coming out in the next week or so because.
Hopefully there's one person they can tell anything to.
Honestly, there's a ton of
They all get around. Like, as soon as I got here, it's like, oh, can I put my bags down? No,
yeah,
you like that, but... Because, at the end of the day, not a lot happens in the shareholders.
Yeah.
And I don't know. What I was thinking about, 8 o'clock in the morning, it's midnight in Aussie, and it's 8 o'clock over. So who's going to be watching at that time?
No one.
Kind of missing. So this is probably a better time.
Alright, you want to, yeah. I got to check my hometown.
Yeah. Fix this camera. That's a good start. Alright.
Who's that good looking fella?
Who's it? Who's this guy? Come here. This is Bunya.
Hey guys. Welcome to all the one people out there. Oh, look, there's another person.
Wait, oh, here we are. Who's this guy?
What? Are we live?
Tony Quick and Charlie Emery. Like, whatever. The owner of Spooky.
Is this just being shown in Australia or is this all over the world?
All over the world.
Wow. You guys with your interwebs are cool.
The interwebs, right?
Yeah.
They're a new fancy thing where people can talk to each other electronically. Yeah, and get information. Guys, we're at Texas Pinball Festival. These guys have been very kind in accepting my demand to stream this. And I'll tell you, it's a good reason. This is what I said to Bunyip, Dave.
Yeah, Dave is probably
better. Dave's probably better. Is that I could not get on any of these machines the last 2 days because people have just been lining up to play them. So that's a really good sign. That's what you want in a show, right?
If people are ignoring you, it's not good.
No, it's exactly right.
We've been at both ends of the spectrum.
Yeah, okay. So I just said, the best way for me to get some gameplay is to stream it. So,
and here we are.
And I just noticed that Bowen signed this one. This is actually a customer's game.
Oh, really?
In Bowen's tutorial yesterday, he ran it all the way to Wizard Mode, which is Million Dollar Babies. And this is a butter cabinet, which is the direct print, beautiful.
I've not seen it. Oh, my God.
And he did a death save. And my first reaction was what the crowd's reaction was, which was like, ooh. And my second reaction was like, oh!
Speak
of the devil.
The man.
Here he is, guys. This is the man, the legend.
Sorry.
And Bowen's here as well.
Oh, wait a minute.
All right, so people are watching. What are we doing? When we come up to this game, what's the first thing that we're trying to do?
Well, the first thing we're trying to do is observe the display that shows when you push start, 50% of the time will show man, 50% of the time will show woman as your
agent. Oh, 50%,
agent
I like
character.
That equality, well
and,
done.
And you two, three, or four players, and you'll see it visually on the screen as four characters. Okay. One of the things I think David Van Ness can talk to this more than I can is the concept that you are a person playing as a character going through the castle. Okay. So you have some agency of like, why am I here? What am I doing? What am I aiming for? Your job is to get into the castle, get out with treasure, basically. And like along the way, you're going to have to find and battle the monsters that are in the castle, the nine monsters on the central display.
And so...
Right off the bat, there's a skill shot on any of the five blinking shots. A ramp or a lock will be worth double the loops. The loops will give you progress to go over a monster. The ramps and the lock will give you a ball save as well as a secret passage.
Okay.
Am I playing? Are you playing? Who's playing this game?
I can play as well. Everyone's demanding that you get the wizard mode on 4-1.
Oh, great. Well, terrific.
No death saves.
I did it yesterday. What are you talking about? That was 4-1, right? No?
With a death save?
No?
That doesn't count. Here we go. So this is Bowen. Let's just freak out, right? This is Bowen on my screen.
Oh, there we go. That's how we work it. That's how we do the stream.
It has a ball save, though.
You said no ball saves. No? All right. So, we wanted the ability for people to change the modes in the way that other games, like, let you select the mode. So the center targets in the middle change the monster mode from whatever's lit to the next one in order. So if I don't like Cold Ethel, I can shoot the targets and miss. And then drink. That's ball one. Boom.
No. That was freaking hot, man.
Now ball two.
Ball two.
Really,
this is where you're going to... He's going to blow it up now, guys. Penn Stadium, thank you for the bits.
Did I mention I'm wicked tired?
You're tired.
There we go. That's a skill shot.
Yeah,
okay. 2 million. It'll lock a ball for a mini multi-ball called Crypts. And it will give me about 15 seconds of ball save on the outlanes. And it'll light Secret Passage.
Okay.
Secret Passage is an instant...
Gets you to the monster.
Instant to the monster. Otherwise, to get to the monster, you shoot the loops. You navigate this map that's on the display.
Yep, gotcha.
So the map will tell you where you are, and when you shoot left or right, it'll advance. So when I shoot the left spinner, it'll advance me to the left of the map. When I shoot the right loop, it'll advance me to the right on the map. And eventually I have to make my way to the monster.
Okay.
So if I shoot the right loop or missing, I get nothing.
Okay.
If I shoot the right loop and missing, I get nothing. Okay. You don't want to see that.
It's very early, guys, and there's probably not been a lot of sleep. Bowen's been up coding all night.
So there's a good loop pass. The right loop.
There it is.
One more right loop will do it. And now, or I could shoot the secret passage and it would do the same thing. But at this point, I've already done it, so I may as well go the rest of the way.
Right.
Once you travel to the monster will be a battle that is an untimed mode that typically takes about a minute and a half to 2 minutes to finish. So it's going to be pretty involved, more involved than the traveling. Really, we want people spending more time doing this than doing the traveling, because this is the meat of the game. But you have to travel the castle to get to the speed.
Okay.
Igor is green shots. He's hiding behind one of the green shots. And I'll get points for every shot, but I'll get the best points for finding the one that is not that one. Don't you know where you are? It's not that one. So I'll bet I know which one it is.
It could only be one more. Nice.
And watch this. So you hit them, you go on to a different level where there's more shots to make.
And does the value increase?
Yes, the value increases. And I'm just not shooting it right, but let's shoot this. Okay, it's not that one. Only four more shots to go. But it's that one.
No, it's going to be the easy targets.
It's definitely that one.
Because you coded it and you know. Was that randomized?
What?
That shot, or is there something that you know that indicates where it is?
It was randomized, but I knew where it was.
Because you've got a computer brain?
No, because I know something that is capable, the players can figure out that the game is giving more information than just what's left.
Gotcha.
I actually don't know where it is now. I only know it's not there. It could be any of the other shots. This is the third final capture. So every shot gives you points and raises the value of the collect by half a million, I think. Quarter million.
Do you know what it is now?
Nope. That's that. There it is, that's the third collect. You get paid again, and now I have 30 seconds of unlimited everything. All the shots are lit for a million. There's a million. And if I continue to do what the mode wanted me to do, which was shoot Igor shots to find him again, I can still get points for that too. And there's a ball save that runs all the way through this bonus time.
Right, okay.
That lets me be aggressive, lets me be just have fun with it because I've already won. And there's 5 million for another collect. That's much more than I was making for the earlier collects. And then in the end, it gives you a hurry up countdown over what you collected, and you have to try to hit that tiny little hurry up target all the way on the left to get one final cash in before, boom!
Oh, there it is.
2.5 million collected again.
That's a big bit of point.
Yeah, so that's one of the lower scoring modes.
Okay.
And I got 70 million with 23. The other rule about modes that I'm really proud of, and I think it's working out well, is every mode you play, the next mode has an increased base value, 20% higher. Every mode, all the way.
Okay.
So if you like a mode, and you're like, I can get a lot of points on werewolves, you can decide to wait and raise it by 20% or 40% or 100% by playing other modes first.
Are the modes fairly balanced as far as difficulty goes? The reason I'm asking that is you might want to just knock off a couple of quick ones to raise the value to then start the harder ones.
So the answer is no. The modes are not balanced by the balance to be equally difficult, and they're not balanced to be equally scoring either, on purpose, so that you can have some of these decisions. Vampire, which I'm about to play next, is the simplest mode to finish. They require 3 shots.
Okay.
And we'll try to get that as fast as we can. We started the mode with Secret Passage.
Oh, Secret Passage, right. Now, how did you like the Secret Passage?
That was awarded to me from the skill shot.
Okay.
But I could also get the Secret Passage by hitting the center bank enough time after traveling. This mode, the top center target on the upper play field is the reward, and I got to hit it 3 times. That's not it. Hey, wait, are you getting drink delivery service here?
For a long time.
How are you getting drink delivery service?
Fame isn't everything.
Did you just try to drink that without taking the straw? The top of the straw is still on, right?
Fair enough.
You gotta get the brand in the right
position. I'm getting my electrolytes, you're getting your caffeine. Well done. This tastes disgusting. I love the song.
All the bodies everywhere. On the chairs, on the floor. On the floor. On the screen, just like some scary dream. They'll be back again. Oh, no! I gotta replay.
I'll let you play another game then.
Yeah, all three. Oh, I failed it.
26, but I've done better than that, Bolin.
You have. I have actually done better than that.
I've been at Bolin.
Okay.
Sanctuary.
See, that should be a skill shot. But it's not because the wall's not locked. You don't have to lock the skill shot. Anyway. What else should we talk about? Talk about multi-balls?
Yes.
So there's two multi-balls. I remember on ball two, I locked the ball behind that top target. That's very much a TNA style. It only has one room for one ball. So you put one ball in there, and then you put pull a second ball there, and it'll become a two-ball multi-ball. However, there's also this, which is that I can just drain instead. And
I like
and
that feature you
not
put
be
in.
Able to talk about what I was trying to talk about there. So let's ignore that.
Feature.
Boo! Boo!
We don't do that here.
Let's do it right. Now we got a dude. I mean, come on, man. Dudes are everywhere in pinball. Alright, so we put one ball in that lock or up the right ramp. I think this is a really cool feature. Up in the upper play field, there are a number of different shots. One of those shots is to drop the ball under the upper play field and just let it go through Cold Ethel. It's going to drop, roll through here, and into that lock.
Okay, but you've got to get it under the flippers.
You have to just drop, basically get it in that hole. There's enough gap that if I drop that, as soon as I drop the flipper, it'll go.
Okay.
And that.
There we go.
It's going to start the multi-ball.
Oh, okay.
Because there was already a ball there. And modes are still available during multi-ball. So if you know you're traveling, you can start a mode by shooting the secret passage or the loots. The pit creature mode is what started now. And I have to shoot the same scoops to find the pit creature.
Thank you for the follow.
Not here. Not here either. That's my favorite line. So in this mode, you have to shoot the three holes. The pit creature's hiding one of those holes. Not here.
Hello.
Woo. Not here either. Yes, I already know that. Yeah, a timer countdown of 15 seconds. I have to hide the ball.
In which one?
Doesn't matter. Wherever I can hide it. But it has to be hidden from view. So think of all the shots that hide the ball. It's background of the basketball or the holes. Put in a hole. Nope. Put in a hole, it starts counting down. And then once it knows the ball is findable again, it kicks it out. Let's stop the countdown. So I make a loop. Tick, 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 tick. And then when it reappears, the timer stops. So as long as the ball's out of play, I'm getting points. I'm getting a jackpot being raised. And if I ever get it down to zero, I will be able to collect that jack. Tick, 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 tick. Oh dear. This is actually a mode where being in the two-ball multi-ball might hurt you. Because as soon as it hits something else, they'll say, oh, there's the ball again.
But is it only counting down when you hit those shots?
When
or
I,
any switch hits?
No, it's only when I'm hit. So when I go around like the right loop, the ball will hide when I hit the loop switch. And we'll know we're back there. So. Ah, jeez.
That's it.
Oh, damn it. Ah, we didn't get to see the end of that. But the creature is a very valuable mode compared to some of the others. Yeah, sorry, I'm definitely playing
worse.
Do you want to go? You're probably better than me right now.
Well, we'll start another game after you finish this one.
All right. What would you like to see next? So I've queued up the Alice Cooper mode, which we can play.
Okay.
Alice Cooper is a guillotine mode. So shoot the secret passage, it starts the mode, you can also do the regular travel if you... The secret passage is a one-shot. You gotta get up top and shoot the guillotine. I think it's the most one-shot in the game. Get up here to every play field, and there's a backflip. Whee! That little like return ramp there. Oh, it's good, we're good. Oh my, that was a big kick. Ah, jeez. Alright, so every shot to the guillotine is
thanks, polar bear.
An increased bonus points. Trying to get that. I let it go on purpose. Yeah, that's the ticket. Get up there. Oh! Oh, God, hurry up, Flint.
Oh, it's the right ramp, I swear.
No, your other ramp.
You're going to go the hard way.
Yeah, hard way. I like hard fairway. All right, well, this is...
Skipping out of you're more than welcome. $507 million?
No, but this one it is.
$549 million.
And the last digit of your number is the number of kills.
Hey, that one's legitimately mine. I'm on the board yet. Yeah.
So if you kill one monster, you get a one at the end of your score, etc., all the way up to 9.
Yeah, okay.
Similar to the reactions on annihilation.
Yeah.
Except in this case, because you can also lose to a monster, you don't get the extra digit for that.
Right,
you
okay.
Only get the digit if you kill the monster. So getting to that number kind of shows the efficiency of the score as well as the value of it.
Okay.
And then if you get to Wizard, the number of kills controls how much life you have when Wizard happens. You want to do a two?
Let's go.
Or three?
Let's bring it in.
All right.
Bring it in.
When are we gonna sack up? Where are we sacking up? Where's Denise at?
Where are
we sacking
up?
You're sacking.
Why is your sack empty?
He's got it.
You got a knife?
Hold on. Like he hasn't been conditioning that sack. You have to touch it. So see mine? Look at this. Look how soft mine is. Touch it.
Your sack.
That is hand. That's hand oil.
Your sack is old.
It's not
old.
Mine
is
fresh. It's called experience.
Yeah, the magnet is pretty great. The magnet has a lot of strength. It has an adjustment in the software similar to dialed in other games so that if it's each individual magnet is slightly different, so the timing, we have it factory checked, so they'll make it work pretty well. But the timing of it be really precise to get the thing to fire at all, let alone have it fly up. I've had it fly up to the lock before. It's amazing. And so people who own the game can adjust that timing down to about 5 or 10 milliseconds so that it makes sure it works. Is this a midnight stream or 9 a.m. stream?
Yeah, what time is it?
Us.
It's a blue stream.
It's late.
It's 1:30.
Party on, man!
Party on, Wayne.
So, no kids watching.
4, 3, what are we doing? 4? Who's in?
Don't let that fall underneath there.
Sacking up.
Alright, good. Hey, that's a nice
sack. We need a sack rack.
Alright, we're 4 players.
I don't have any more sack racks.
Go to Pinball Life and get a sack rack.
I have one upstairs, maybe. I've been giving them out.
All I got is 50
Ajiha, we're gonna play, man.
Good lord!
What the hell?
Bowen, I think those odds are that's commendable.
If I can beat Bowen, I deserve that $50.
What are you doing up so early in the morning?
I'm playing against Bowen.
Well,
he can just. Bowen, I'm not gonna win, so Bowen can just owe me $1 if I beat him.
Oh,
I'll give
you $50. All right, Scott, let's go first.
Yeah.
Everybody,
we got Warren.
Scott freaking Denisi.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Internet. My name's Jack Danger. All right. Here it goes. Let's do stuff.
We can have a long discussion about that when I come back.
You guys are in trouble
now. Oh, we go straight for the Denisi locks.
You guys are in trouble.
Imagine that.
Oh, yeah.
You guys are in trouble.
Predictable.
I don't know how to lock them all any other way.
All right, that was fine. You know what? I don't want to. I don't want to play too well, you know.
Thank you, man.
Likely excuse.
Yeah, so it's okay. Oh, I don't want Alice Cooper either. Oh, I locked it in already. That's a problem.
Yeah, shoot the guillotine. Secret passage, guys.
I want to actually win, so Alice Cooper, I struggle with. Oh, I don't need that shot. Sorry, I missed it. Oh my god, that was saveable.
That was beautiful.
That was saveable.
I'll go second. Oh, nothing worse than walking up and soaking out loud on your own game, right?
Skip, I love you.
I am worse than Scott Denisi.
No, you're not. Ball save. Oh, I spent yesterday making fun of Thunderbirds a whole bunch and started actually liking it. That's a problem. No, I started liking it. It's not good. I might have to get one now. Seriously.
Ah.
Oh yeah, I did. I'm helping him do the some stuff. I'm just asking.
I'm gonna go get some more coffee and get better.
He's a really, really good dude. Yeah.
All right, here we go, guys. My second ever game.
Oh, is that how you do that? Can you explain this one to me?
What did he do? Why has he got so many points?
He hit the skill shot. Good one. I hit the stupid scoop. It isn't worth anything.
He's just a nice guy. I just want to touch him.
Please, go ahead. If a guy's nice, you just walk around and start touching
him. Yeah, I guess. I mean, I like nice guys.
I do too.
Hey, that was my ball.
Well, don't come up with a silly mechanism of lock stealing behind a bloody Denisi lock. You don't want to pay the consequences.
Oh, okay. You need the center scoop and you can clear go. That's worth a view.
Worth a view?
That's worth a view.
Zorno is crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
In my head when it does like, you don't exactly know what's coming up. Like,
now, Bowen would just backhand the left orbit, but.
Oh, yeah, I want to try
the left ramp. Oh.
I want to see, I'm going to try the left ramp back.
I can't do those things on my own game.
Come on.
Check
up,
check
up.
Oh, drop catch with a spin. Get burned by the spin.
This feels really good, this guy.
All right, what are we doing? What are we doing?
We're playing.
All right, we're just going to kick everybody's ass.
We're playing for keys.
Bar has been set very low.
Very low.
I don't know. There's 6 million over there. It's not bad.
That's pretty good.
Lock is lit. Oh, I'm going to steal it. I'm in your locks, stealing your locks.
Skip, did you do that on stream? Because I don't believe you. But I do believe you, because you don't lie to me.
Who blew up Reactor 9?
Yeah, Skip Daddy.
Nice job, man. That's awesome.
Nine balls.
We'll see. Hold on. If you did it on stream,
I have not been there myself.
both.
Oh, he didn't do it on stream. You know what that means, Skip? That means you gotta do it again. And I love you.
I still believe you anyway. So Bullet needs, what, 3 or 4 ramp shots to electrocute Frankenstein?
It's 3 ramps.
There's only a few people that have actually done it on stream. He blew up Reactor 9 on DNA. One of the guys in the chat here is Skip Daddy.
Oh, really?
Yeah. There's been, so Bowen did it on stream.
Like, because he stole my lock, it actually puts a million onto my score. That's pretty cool.
No, he doesn't get any of my multi-ball value. He gets a million. Fat Panda,
hello.
He gets a million for the stolen lock.
I like that.
And I can shut that off to the software for competitive play quite easily. So, nobody, like, rings up.
That's
kind of
cool.
That's
kind of cool competitive pay, though.
Yeah, it's like it's a little co-op, a little cooperative. You're like, oh, I stole it, but hey, I got paid. Experimenting with it. I think it's fun. Shots, then shoot the monster mode shot. But every time you shoot a shot, it shuts off and becomes dangerous to you instead.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna practice.
suggest something.
I think it's special
though,
man. I've actually played on their podcast twice. They don't do that very often.
Yeah, true.
Pinball here. This has been my Texas Pinball Festival. It's been amazing.
Simone, how much is frenzy time worth? Is it 27 or 30 seconds?
30 seconds.
30 seconds. So once you beat Simone, you have a 30 second frenzy time. You cannot.
Oh! Close it!
Did a 10 ball save off.
You asked me if the Wizard Pump ball won, so I don't know what you want.
That is true.
Swish!
There's definitely nothing obstructing your view, seeing guy.
Six more.
Swish.
Five more.
Swish.
Oh, come on, we're gonna get this.
Richard, get your credit card out. Go and buy one.
Hello, Ann.
What?
Just reach out to you.
For God's sake.
KT, that's not
here.
K,
right?
The
not
letter
here.
T at spookypinball.com. She'll get you taken care of. Or Delvin, Chris.
Like, he's constantly got ball saver. They are bow and hacks. Right there.
Well, it may be that we don't want there to be as much ball saves long term in the game. I don't find them to be that intrusive because
I actually push the button.
But like the other games, Bob Zombie and TNA have this opportunity to complete the letters and save to start a ball savers. And on both of those games, they're complete ball savers for the whole playfield. But we chose here to do it for just the outlays. That's where that magnet comes in.
Found him!
Mystery jar! Time having beaten the mode, you can't lose for 30 seconds.
Yep.
I would say probably for tournaments we would set that off. But like TNA has this thing, that was inspired by this. TNA has something where if you kill a reactor, it adds a 5 second ball save. So if you blow up a reactor, you immediately drain. It's like, yes! No! No! Damn it! And your moment of like really being happy about it is gone. So by adding that ball save there, I got the 20 million, and, aw, damn it. Well, Ball save. Oh, great, great. I got it. And all of that is just a balancing act. I agree that I've probably gotten too many ball saves. But I know where they are and I know how to get them. And I know the rules.
Being Bowen myself, I think they're fine.
I would like more myself.
All right, let's look at that.
Lenny Balkin, this is a great game, man.
I like that. Okay. I'm buying it.
Sue Igor?
It's a
and layout, but the shot, there's a lot of shots. Lots of hidden shots. Rules are great. Doesn't feel like any other game, but shoots really well. I reckon you'd like this.
How many
things I can beat ball in?
You can beat ball. I totally believe you can.
All I gotta do is take my hands out the flippers
more. I risked $50 on this game. I gotta get back into Frankenstein. There you go. No flip. Backhand.
It's going crazy over here.
Should I stop?
No, don't
okay.
Stop.
Alright, good. That really unlikely to stop. Don't want to stop.
No!
Don't stop unless you want to lose a dollar.
Don't stop till you
get it off.
I'm working on my pinball shit talking. That's pretty good, huh?
I like it.
Yeah.
I like it.
I don't need that stuff. Oh, let's have it!
Here's the magnet.
So, one of the things strategically that you can do in Annihilation is leave yourself one of those save lights. We don't have that in this game. You can effectively do it by getting three out of the four lanes and then waiting. Don't complete them. Wait, use the fourth one to complete save. That allows you to basically have the save available untimed, where if I complete the four letters, it comes on for about 15, 20 seconds and then it's gone. If I leave three and I strategically lane play, I can have that ready whenever I want. It makes his strategic lane play on TNA is fantastic. I didn't want that rule to be copied over, but I want something where like you can still lane play and do something valuable for yourself.
You know what I do on TNA for the lane saves? I save them up at ball three and I just cash them in whenever I can.
Nice. Base values of this are much higher than they were last time. And that's the effect of it being mode 7 or mode 8 or whatever it is. Oh, there is that.
Oh, got it.
We got double eagle over here. Top, 7 full, boom, 47 million bonus.
How much?
someone else can play. Oh no, sorry, it's Ball.
Sorry, it's Ball.
Yeah, that was his one ball.
So we're over here explaining to the police officers why he's getting so excited. And they just said we have to unplug the game.
Okay.
It's getting too rowdy.
Alright, good.
Yeah.
Oh boy. Someone's asking about the multiplier to 248. They're used as cumulative, so when you get to 6x multiplier, light up the 2 and the 4, and then it'll light up the 8. These are bonus X. The maximum bonus X is 14x if you light them all. It's hard to get a bonus X. You gotta do both of those lights, X at the top, and then this light at the bottom.
Okay.
It'll carry your progress ball to ball, so the bonus X is already lit. Because I completed those and didn't get this last ball. And bonus is all cumulative, so everything you have stays with you.
You're gonna get it back.
We'll see. We might not be on.
What's going on?
I think we get the chance.
Oh, you get it back.
She's talking about the internet now.
I think he's got another ball. He's got another extra ball.
I don't know. You're gonna get your name.
There's two extra balls in the game. One is for three monsters encounter, and the other is for 10 BG tops. 10 right ramps. Not that ramp, but the other, the mini ramp. Never mind the ramp.
Why am I not following you?
Of everything, so
all you have to do is throw a football, right?
Yep.
Hey, he's beaten every monster he's played.
Cooper, stand in your way. Run! Run! All right, we gotta shoot blue arrows to advance up the tower. There are 19 floors to go, and I can escape right now for 10 million if I want to, or I can go up. Every time I advance a floor, I get points. If I go in a hole, it gives me a chance to escape. I can leave with 10 million right now.
Hit that.
F that.
Oh,
so luck.
Oh, there goes.
Yeah, pressure luck is it. Yeah. You know pressure luck. Pressure luck. But if you hit it in a red shot,
oh, yeah, if you're not hit the red, yeah.
You will lose a life point.
Looks like you hit it.
Or more than that. How much time we got? 24 seconds.
Looks like you got faster. You got plenty of time to hit the vampire.
I don't have plenty of time. Oh, that's 24 seconds. We had 16 seconds already.
Oh, I didn't even get it.
Oh.
Got it.
Oh.
I know. Seven.
I love it.
Six. Five. Four.
Dude, that was awesome.
Oh, no.
Great job, man.
Hello.
But that was the wizard mode.
That was the wizard mode.
I said to Bowen before we started, I said, I want you to get to wizard mode on ball one. That was technically wizard mode on ball one.
Yeah, in regulation too.
Within regulation.
Three regular balls, but damn. That's one.
Good job, Bob. Me, I think. Me. Hey guys, look, I'm back.
It's so long ago. I can't remember.
You guys, I'm back. I'm back. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually show you how to play this game for real.
Oh, there we go.
And not, you know, put the cheat codes in.
Thank you.
She's a very nice lady. Okay, guys, you ready? Let's do it. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to, I can probably backhand this guy, I can't do that. All right, I need to get that out, the thing there. Okay, all right. It's fine. It's all good. Okay, okay.
Got vampire, got evil.
All right.
All right, honey, all you have to do is beat Bowen's score.
It's fine, I got it. I just have to, you know.
I think what happens is that guy who came
from that doesn't count. That doesn't count. I got to get the thing there. Okay.
Right,
I'm gonna try and backhand this guy. Okay. That's how you do it. Secret pass.
We were gonna send the clock up to the
Okay. Alice Cooper, you are mine. Oh, man.
Here we go. Oh, this
thing.
I got it. I got it. I just can't get the. I just can't get, you know.
Oh, here we go.
Can't, like,
oh,
people look bad, you know?
Okay,
here we go. I'll try again.
Hit the right side.
The ball game is just lucky. It was also lucky.
Oh, what am I doing? Oh, I'm only. Oh, never mind. It only takes one ball.
They were tied. See?
him!
So I now run the second biggest tournament in Australia, right? And that's one of the reasons why I just
made
the bonus
over here.
Chopper. Yeah, you're running my car and see what I can do.
Get in the left scoop.
So when I started Melbourne Silver Ball League, which was the first tournament, we used to always stream the finals. And so it was just gave me an excuse to learn.
Here we go. I got skills.
My turn. All right, Joey, get out of here.
This is called giving the other three players a snowball's chance.
Snowball chance.
My thoughts you will get.
Let's see if I can backhand it. In a minute. There we go. Bash, bash, bash.
Loose flip, yeah. The art on this is amazing, yeah. And it looks better, even better in person. Oh! Thanks, CNK.
If I can start one more mode on my last ball, I can still get an extra ball. Or no, I can't. That is last ball.
That's last ball.
Not last place. Woo!
Yeah, okay, I'm now gonna beat Charlie.
DFL, guys.
That's it. Just do that one more time. And I can be like, hey, I was on head. I only finished second to bowl.
Hey, internet. I want to tell you guys something. There's a term in pinball called DFL, which is what I do a lot. It's called dead fucking last.
Yeah.
That's me. DFL Scotty.
He's in orbit. There you go. He's locked. There you go. One more.
Doing now.
Hey, show me your shirt, Scott.
it.
Just blew this up. Melbourne Silver Bull League and head-to-head, we're going to be dining out on video footage of this for a year.
That's the best streaming content you've had in some time.
Yeah, absolutely. Except for my drunken rants, but...
Drunken rants are the best.
My drunken rants are awesome.
Why don't we have one of those right now?
Well, we could.
We can make that happen. Yeah.
No, but we're going to shut down the stream, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks to Bowen. Thanks to Charlie. Dave Van Ness was here before. Thanks to Spooky. Thanks to everyone. Oh, Scott Denisi was here before. This machine's amazing. So, buy one. See you guys.
Thanks.
What's up, everybody?